हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर वीडियो ऑफ जियोग्राफी चैप्टर 7 ह्यूमन एनवायरनमेंट सेटलमेंट ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड कम्युनिकेशन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी स्टडीड अबाउट सेटलमेंट। टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस अबाउट ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड कम्युनिकेशन। ट्रांसपोर्ट, पीपल नीड टू मूव फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर फॉर वर्क, टू बाय एंड सेल गुड्स, टू विजिट रिलेटिव्स एंड फ्रेंड्स, फॉर मेडिकल हेल्प एंड टू एंजॉय वैकेशंस। वेरियस मीन्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट help in the movement of people and goods. Relief features and economic activities determine the development of transport of a region. At present, all forms of transport are easily accessible, thus serving as a means of all-round development. The four major forms of transportation are roadways, railways, waterways, and airways. Roadways. Roadways are the most widespread and universal mode of transport all over the world. They are a common means of transporting goods and passengers over short distances. Roads may be metalled, means pakka, or unmetalled, means kaccha. The maximum number of roads are in the plains. But now, roads also connect mountains, deserts, and forests. Roads built underground. Roads built underground are called subways or underpasses, while roads built at an elevation from the ground level are called flyovers. Roads built at an elevation from the ground level are called flyovers. Today, most countries have modern highways that connect different parts of the state or country. They are called state highways and national highways respectively. The national highway system has been developed to link various cities in India too. The Manali Leh Highway of India. The Manali Leh Highway of India is one of the highest roadways in the world. The Manali Leh Highway of India is one of the highest roadways in the world. Next, railways. Railways provide a quick means of transport over long distances that can carry people and goods to all parts of the country. The development of railways is affected by the terrain. Terrain means land and climate of the region, and density of population, availability of natural resources, and the level of economic and technological development. Electric and diesel engines are able to travel at a very fast speed, and hence super fast trains run on many routes. This makes railway journeys faster and more comfortable. With modern technology, railways have been able to connect places even in hilly and forested areas. Indian railway network is well developed. It is the largest in Asia. Next, waterways. Waterways are another important means of transport. They are the cheapest mode of transport for carrying goods from one place to another through water bodies like canals, rivers, seas, and oceans. Another advantage of waterways is that no routes have to be made for them. They use natural routes like rivers and seas. Waterways are of two types. They are inland waterways and sea routes. Inland waterways. Navigable lakes, canals, and rivers make up the inland waterways. They are very economical in transportation of heavy goods like coal, grains, and ore. Some important inland waterways are the Great Lakes in North America, Ganga Brahmaputra River system in India, and River Nile in Egypt. Important canals that serve as important inland waterways are the Suez Canal in Egypt, Panama Canal in America, and the Kiel in Germany. Sea routes. Sea and oceans routes are used to transport goods and people from one country to another country. These routes are connected by seaports. Some important ports are Tokyo, Shanghai, London, Cape Town, New York, Bombay, and Sydney in Australia, Rotterdam in Europe. Airways. Airways is the fastest mode of transport developed in the early 20th century. It can reach remote forest and mountainous regions, which otherwise are inaccessible by road and rail. Goods and medicines can be transported by air to places affected by natural disasters. However, air transport is expensive and may get disrupted by bad weather like fog, rain, and storm. There are two types of air services. They are domestic and international. Domestic airlines carry passengers and cargo within a country, while international airlines carry goods and passengers from one country to another country. USA, Europe, and Southeast Asia have well-developed airways. The main international airports of the world are London, Tokyo, Washington, New York, Shanghai, Delhi, Mumbai, Paris, Frankfurt, Dubai, Melbourne, and Sydney. Next topic, communication. The process of conveying and receiving information and ideas is called communication. The process of conveying and receiving information and ideas is called communication. The two types of communication are personal and mass communication. Personal communication involves only two or more people. Communication with many people at the same time is called mass communication. Communication with many people at the same time is called mass communication. Mass communication is done through internet, newspapers, books, radio, television, and films. The means of personal communication include post and telegraphic system, teleprinter, telephone, email, and fax. In olden days, people sent messages through animals, birds, by beating drums. Then people started writing letters, which were delivered by road, rail, or air. With the advancement in technology, wireless means of communication like telephone, telegraph, radar, and satellites were developed. With the help of satellites, we can make weather forecasts, warn about natural disasters, and conduct oil and mineral exploration. Communication has become faster and convenient with the invention of electronic mail or email, cellular phones, and fax machines. All these means of communication provide information, education, and entertainment and made our lives more comfortable. Now we can reserve tickets for railways, airways, and even cinemas and hotels sitting at home. So, satellites have made communication easier and faster. The development of fax, email through internet and mobile phones have enhanced the speed of communication. That's why the world has now become a large global society. Students, I just hope I make you understand and clear the concept. Thank you.